to fight fires in rural. The boys brought the equipment out for us while we were there visiting with them. Here they come out with their emergency squad, town and township, in the saving of life with this piece of emergency equipment. Now they're bringing their pumper back in, and they're going to show us another of their operation that today.
My name is Ernest Adams. I'm in the Junior Division of the Junior Fire Department. My name is Joe Adams. I'm in the Junior Division of the Fairborn Department.
Kenneth Edwards. I'm the Chief of the Fairborn Fire Department.
In the Junior Fire Department, you learn about the safety at your home and at your school. Civil defense, and when we're all finished with the meeting, we go into the back room and have our eats.
Fire department also has means for recreation. This is their rec hall above the apparatus house, and you'll see that it's well equipped and that they have a good time there. To the left is their kitchen, and it certainly is a fine kitchen. Boys meet here in the evenings, shoot pool, play a friendly game of cards, and in the fellowship which they develop, they have the nucleus for a wonderfully functioning fire department. The gentleman who just shot is the chef of the Fairborn Fire Department. Not the chief, but the chef. They're really enjoying their game of pool. Oh, something went wrong. There goes the whistle. In this department, one man immediately goes to the middle of the street and blocks traffic. And here comes Tiny. He had to come running to catch the apparatus. Look at him go. Blocking traffic and holding traffic until the apparatus gets out and down the street. Pumper out first, then comes the tanker. There goes that portable cistern I spoke about. If they're on their way to a rural fire, it'll really help. There's the emergency car, their second pumper, third pumper, fourth pumper, and remember there's still a civil defense car in reserve. But as always happens, someone gets hurt. One of the men, in opening the door of the engine house, mashed his thumb badly, and the first aid crew takes over.
Men decided to put on a farm inspection for us. We have now gone out to a farm in Bath Township where the lieutenant briefs his men before engaging in the inspection on the farm.
Lieutenant Richard Chance of the 51 Farm Department.
Need more roads.
Making a farm inspection. Ralph Trollinger, you inspect the house here and notice more or less the wiring, the heating control units, and things that's lying around there that might be a fire hazard on the farm here. Well, Frank Short, you will inspect the outbuildings here and in the corn crib. Notice all these hazardous conditions that might be in the surrounding area and put these on your forms. Perry, you and I will inspect the barn here. We'll notice all these hazards in here in the hay mow, and also the wiring of the barn. Joe, will you pass out the forms so these fellows can fill in the forms of the hazards and what they find on this farm, and also write down where the water supply is, the main source on this farm, and we will meet back at the firehouse in Fairborn.
As the lieutenant comes in, he distributes forms to each individual so that they may record the results of their inspection of this premises. They then proceed to the barn. They check the wiring. They note that it's Romex, installed in conformance with good modern practice. Light bulbs are checked. Fuse box is looked into. Proper size fuse is evident. No smoking signs have been posted. That light would be better if it had a guard. This is the inside of the barn, which was built to replace the one which had burned down 2 years ago when struck by lightning. Nice looking barn, isn't it? A lot of hay left over, too. The main switch The lieutenant makes an entry in his inspection record. Then go outside and check the fuel supply. The hose is checked to be sure that an automatic closing device is provided in the event it's dropped. The lightning rods are looked at, and the grounds are thoroughly checked. The motor is looked at in the machinery shed. Chimneys are examined. Repairs would not be amiss. Wiring is checked in the milk house. It's found to be installed in conformance with good modern practice. We then left the farm, the Needmore Road, and proceeded up the road a mile to this location, the very opposite of the other farm, trash littering the entire area and a multitude of hazards present. I wonder what they were saving the old crankcase oil for. The captain briefs his group, points out the very obvious hazards present, and makes the necessary plans for the elimination of these hazards. When buildings of this kind occupy rural areas, it's small wonder that fire losses are heavy. In substandard areas such as this, losses are high, lives are lost, and the fire department is kept busy. The captain now brings one of his crew in to point out a special situation that needs attention. Which is substandard to say the least. Through the medium of these inspections, we have hoped to show you how a rural fire inspection program works. Has been limited, but we do feel that if this program is adopted by fire departments serving rural areas and cooperation established between those fire departments and the farmers or residents in rural areas, increased fire safety will certainly result.